Hello students, welcome to my channel. This is Kiran Potna. In this video you will get interaction of surface areas and volumes. This is your 10th class one of the chapter, and this is very important topic. Why? Because not only in 10th class you will get the question based on surface area, curved surface area and volume, so continuation also will be there in class 12, nothing but in Karnataka second PSC. In second PSC maths also you will get these type of problems, nothing but. So we have a chapter that is application of derivatives in second year, okay, nothing but second PC. So there we will use this concept. So without knowing this concept you cannot do it. So the surface areas and volumes, not only in your 10th class, this is also helpful in your further studies also. So that's why you have to learn it perfectly. So first, what do you mean by surface area? Okay, surface area means surface area is the amount of space covering the outside of a three-dimensional shape. Okay, surface area andre amount of space covering outside, nothing but, for example, if you consider this as a shape, so whatever it is, it covers like this everything, okay, on the top, side, bottom, everything, that surface area, whatever it will cover, that will consider surface area. Now when come to curved surface area, that will represent with CSA. That a CSA of a solid is the measurement of outer area, okay, only outer area, where the extension of top and bottom portion won't be included. Curved surface area andre only this part, okay, only this part, nothing but surrounded part, except that upside and downside portion we won't consider. Now when comes to volume, the amount of space that is contained within an object or solid shape. For example, if we consider this as a vessel, if we pour some water into it, how much water we can pour into it, that we will consider as volume. Nothing but amount of space that is contained within an object or solid shape we will consider as volume. Now, see, this is the important figures which we have to know before trying to solve the surface areas and volumes. Why? Because these are the types of figures used in this chapter. One is cube, okay. You know it is cuboid, next it is cylinder, and then cone and sphere and hemisphere, nothing but off of this sphere is called hemisphere. So we should know about all these six figures, and the complete detail information also you should know. Now I will describe these one by one, and I will give the formulas also where we have to use in the coming questions, okay. So first I will describe about the cube here. So let us see students. Okay, now the first figure is cube. In this cube, so this we will consider as length and the breadth, and it is rectangle. Now here in the for length we will consider as A, and breadth is also A, and height is also A. Why? Because cube is nothing but we will get from that square only, so that's why this is A into A into A. Now how to find total surface area? Total surface area means we have to consider the front side, back side, left and right, top and bottom, all the surface areas we need to find. So the total surface area, how many surfaces we are having is 6 surfaces we are having. To find one area is A square. So total surface area will become 6 A square. Okay, this is 6 A square. Now curved surface area. Curved surface area means except this top and bottom, remaining 4 sides, nothing but front, back, left, right, those 4 surface areas, one surface area is A square. So 4 sides we will have except top and bottom, so it will become 4 A square. Next, volume. See how to find volume of a cube. So volume of a cube is nothing but length into breadth into height. Here as it is a cube, so length, breadth, height both are equal only, so nothing but A into A into A, which means it is A cube. Okay, next it is second figure. It is cuboid. So cuboid, it looks like a brick like that. So this length, this side I will consider as length, and this is, we can call it as width or breadth, and this is height. Okay, and when comes to total surface area, total surface area means this front and back, that left and right, and top and bottom, total all surface areas we need to find. To find one surface area, see, if you find that front surface area, we need length into height. Okay, so similarly front to back, two times of like length into height we need, plus to find this area. So we need breadth into height, nothing but 2b into h. Why? Because front and this is back, and top and bottom. Top we need length and width. Okay, so it will become 2 into lb. So finally we can write total surface area formula is 2 times of lb plus bh plus hl. Okay, so this is the total surface area. Now to find curved surface area, curved surface area means top and bottom we need to remove. If we remove top and bottom, we need only this front, back and left, right portions only. That formula is 2 times of lh plus bh. Okay, these two. Now when comes to volume, volume is nothing but l into b into h, similar to cuboid, but in cuboid all size these lengths are equal, a into a, that's why it is a cube. But here it is l into b into h. Now the third part, that is cylinder. So in cylinder also two types will be there. One is total surface area and it is curved surface area. Curved, okay, first I will tell you curved surface area. Curved surface area means we won't get top and bottom, okay, except this top and bottom part. Okay, remaining part whatever we get, so that only that we will consider as curved surface area. Okay, except the top and bottom, this curved surface area, round part we will consider as curved surface area. To find that curved surface area, the formula is 2 pi r h. Okay, 2 pi r h. Now to find total surface area, we need upper part also and again this below part also. How to find surface area of this circle? Circle we know that is 2 pi r, okay, pi r square. But top also is one circle is there, bottom also one circle is there, so it will become 2 pi r square plus. Now this curved surface area, right, understood? So total surface is nothing but top and bottom surface area plus curved surface area. Top and bottom is 2 pi r square plus bottom surface area, that is 2 pi r h. So what we can take common is 2 pi r common we can take, so we can write as r plus h. Okay, so this is the formula for total surface area. Okay, now when comes to volume, so volume of a cylinder is pi r square h, pi r square h. Okay, so here what is r? That r means the radius, r means radius, this is the height. Okay, this will called as height. Okay, so that's why it will become volume is pi r square h. Now the fourth figure, that is cone. In that cone also we can find three different types of values. One is total surface area, curved surface area, and then it is volume. So first I will tell you volume. So volume is 1 by 3 pi r square h. Okay, volume is 1 by 3 pi r square h. Why? Because if you observe this cylinder, this cylinder volume is pi r square h. So that cone is nothing but see, for example, if I drawn here one cylinder, okay, let it be a cylinder. If I take a cone here, so we will get three parts. This is one part, okay, this is another part, and this is three part. Nothing but cone will be like one third of that cylinder. So that's why volume is 1 by 3 pi r square h. Okay, next. Now when comes to curved surface area, curved surface area means only this part. Okay, top part won't be there, only this part. Okay, this won't be there, top part. Now how to find that curved surface area is, for that cone it is pi r l, pi r l. So what is that l? Means that slant height. Okay, l means slant height, r means we know that is radius, r is radius. Okay, so here volume I have written pi r square h. H means here height, h means height of that cone. Now total surface area, total surface area will represent with TSA. It includes that above area, nothing but circle area, and again this curved surface also. We know one circle we are having, one circle means that area is pi r square plus. Now curved surface also we need to add, curved surface is pi r l. So if we can take pi r common, we will get r plus l. Okay, this is the formula for total surface area. Next, it is sphere. Sphere means it is like a circle, but it is a solid 3D figure. So in that both total surface area and curved surface area will be equal. Why? Because there will be no top and bottom like that. So total it will be like a sphere, na? So total surface area or curved surface area, both are equal in this case. So to find the total surface area or curved surface area, the formula is 4 pi r square. Okay. Next, when comes to volume, volume of a sphere is 4 by 3 pi r cube. 4 by 3 pi r cube, where r is called radius. Where r is called radius. Next, hemisphere. Hemisphere is nothing but half of that sphere. Okay, only half of that. Half of that means, like if we consider here, see, in this also two parts will be there. In a sphere, there won't be any total and curved, both are equal. But in hemisphere, top part will be there, na? Top. Okay, this part if we include, that will become total surface. If we did not include, that will become curved surface area. In hemisphere, total surface area, nothing but including this curved surface area and also the top. Okay, that total surface area formula is 2 pi r square plus pi r square, which means 3 pi r square. Okay, why? Because here total surface area is 4 pi r square. In that half is 2 pi r square, nothing but this curved surface area. Sorry, this is 3 pi r square. Okay, curved surface area we know, that is 2 pi r square plus top is there, na, that circle part, that is pi r square. 2 pi r square plus pi r square, which gives 3 pi r square. Now when comes to volume, so hemisphere is half of the sphere, that means volume of sphere by 2, so that is 4 by 3 pi r cube by 2. So half of this sphere area is 2 by 3 pi r cube. So this is the formula of volume, curved surface area and total surface area. Okay friends, once again we will recall all the formulas. So pause the video and note down all these formulas here. Now here first one is cube. Total surface area, TSA, nothing but 6a square for the cube. When length is a, breadth is a and height is a. So it will become a into a cube. Next it is cuboid. Total surface area is equal to, we will consider as TSA, that is 2 times of length into breadth plus breadth into height plus h into l. Next one, it is curved surface area. Curved surface area means except the top and bottom, remaining 4 sides, front, back, left and right, that surface area is 2 times of l into h plus b into h. Next, volume of a cuboid, that is length into breadth into height. Okay. Next, when come to third solid figure, that is cylinder. In cylinder, 2 types of areas will be there, that is one is total surface area and curved surface area. Total surface area means including the tops, top and bottom. If we include top and bottom, total circle will be there, bottom also circle will be there. So that is one is pi r square, so it will become 2 pi r square plus curved surface area is 2 pi r h. So total it will become 2 pi r of r plus h. Now when come to curved surface, except top and bottom, only curved surface, that is 2 pi r h. Next, volume is pi r square h. Next, fourth one, cone. So cone is also 2 types, total surface area, curved surface area. Total surface means above part won't be there, so that's why this surface only will consider curved surface area, that is pi r l. If we consider total surface area, curved surface area plus that above area, above is nothing but circle. Circle is pi r square plus pi r l, which gives pi r of r plus l. When comes to volume of a cone, 1/3 of the volume of a cylinder, that is 1 by 3 pi r square h, where pi r square h is the formula of a cylinder. Next, sphere. So sphere, it will be like this circle shape, where r is radius. So both total surface area and curved surface area both are same, that is 4 pi r square. When come to volume, it is 4 by 3 pi r cube when come to sphere. Next, it is hemisphere, half of the sphere. Total surface area, TSA, is 2 pi r square plus pi r square, which is 3 pi r square. Curved surface area, we will call it as CSA, that is 2 pi r square. Now when come to volume, so it is volume of a sphere divided by 2, nothing but 2 by 3 pi r cube. Now based on this, you will get the questions. So those figures also I will draw, which type of questions you may get. Like there will be a cone. Okay, above that they will place hemisphere. Okay, like this. you need to find the total height. It may be you need to find height, okay, or you may need to find the slant height of this cone, or else curved surface area they will ask CSA of total they will ask nothing but curved surface area of cone plus curved surface of hemisphere you need to find, or else sometimes they'll give cube, okay, you know, cube, it will be like this. For that cube they will place hemisphere like this, hemisphere they will place, you need to find total area, that may be volume like that, okay. So these type of questions they will ask in surface areas and volumes. Remember all the figures and formulas so that you can solve the questions very easily. Thank you so much. Thank you.